सजन चले कहाँ तुम विनती करी तेरी पाप पड़े तोरे कितना मनाया फिर भी नहीं सुनी रे छोड़ के कहाँ चले गिरत रात अंधेरा डरावे लोहित मोहे रुलावे पंछी अकेला सुना है बसेरा वाट तकत तोरे आवन की छोड़ के कहाँ चले
Maka kun pahar ki khorote bat saisa khurar paja ki udong rakhim hokol khole moi ki man kandim তাকে এক মনে ভাবিছা লিয়েন মাকা
এণ্ড দিছ ইজ শ্বিলং পিক দ্য খাসিজ বিলিভ দিছ পিক ইজ দ্য লেজেণ্ডেৰী এবৰ্ড অফ উবলাই শ্বিলং দ্য ক্ৰিয়েটৰ এণ্ড প্ৰটেক্টৰ অফ শ্বিলং দিছ ইজ দ্য হাইষ্ট পইণ্ট ইন মেঘালয় অৰ শ্বিলং প্লেটো Located 10 kilometers away from Shillong proper, about 300 meters off the road that connects Shillong with Moflang, is this exquisitely beautiful waterfall, which has been named as Elephant Falls, not only for its grace and majestic look, but for the depth of water and for the width of the waterfall. The surroundings of the Elephant Falls and its subsidiary waterfalls are lush, green and thick. And the rivulet that causes these waterfalls has very thick moss, lichens and ferns that keep the stony banks covered. Then the myriad species of ever-chirping birds that make the place one out of a book of fairy tales and dreams. The climate of Meghalaya is generally very humid. It's directly influenced by the southwest monsoon and the northeast winter winds. 20 kilometers away from Shillong, we arrived at Moflang, sacred forests. The sacred forests are one of pristine wonder. Meghalaya's traditional sacred forests, as the world over, are steeped in spiritual belief and held in great veneration. They also represent some of the earliest representations of preserving the ancient ecosystem. the sacred forests are revered like another incarnation of the Almighty. The Khasi term for a sacred grove is Kilaw Kintang, meaning a sacred forest. Sometimes they also call it Kilaw Adog, meaning a prohibited forest, where cutting of trees is strictly not permitted. The ground of the sacred groves is covered with a thick cushion of humus accumulated over the centuries. The journey through the Northeast is always amazing. Like this footpath constructed way back in 1827 by David Scott, agent to the governor of Bengal for the Northeast frontier. This path, which he used to journey into the heart of the Khasi Hills over 200 years ago, was built by him. Portions of the path that came to be known as the David Scott Path still exists. This path was constructed in 1827, and David Scott, then being an agent to the governor of Bengal, at a time when Assam and the present northeastern region had not yet become a part of British India. Scott, in fact, is credited with having laid the first land route linked between Bengal and Assam, a bridle path which actually connected Chatak in East Bengal, now Bangladesh, with Rani Kudam in Assam. Scott is credited for the establishment and expression for the British administration in the entire northeast of India. And he was also one of the first to have realized there were possibilities of pushing a trade route across the Assam-Burma frontier into Upper Burma and even to China. David Scott, however, died young at the age of 46. And this memorial here aptly and proudly recalls the edifying qualities of a person whose pioneering initiatives indeed changed the fate of northeastern region forever. If David Scott had worked relentlessly to expand and consolidate the British rule in the Khasi Hills, it was U Tirot Singh, the Siam or chieftain of Nong Khlaw, who fought to push the British out of their territory. But when he found that the British had intentions to remain here to rule and exploit, he built up a strong resistance movement in 1828. And on the 4th of April, 1829, he and his troops launched a massive attack on the British, killing one after another, two British officers, Burlton and Bentingfield at Nong Khlaw. Tirot Singh's struggle continued for 5 years until in June 1833, he was arrested and sent to the Dhaka Central Jail. The career of one of the most heroic yet little known figures of the history of India ended 8 years later in 1841. Leaving history behind, the unit members were excited to go to Cherrapunji. Cherrapunji, the wettest place on earth, better known as Sohra in the local language, or Chera by the British. Cherrapunji, in fact, was the first civil and military station of the British in the Meghalaya Plateau. The British actually came up to Meghalaya Plateau from East Bengal, present Bangladesh. And it was David Scott who set up the Cherrapunji station in the year 1829. In fact, Cherrapunji was even declared capital of Assam in the year 1832. Though that did not take place in reality, as the British administration began to run from Guwahati. Heavy rains and a wildfire soon compelled the British to shift their station base to Shillong. and that was around the year 1865 to 1866. Cherrapunji is located 56 kilometers south of Shillong and in the southern region of Meghalaya, which itself is the rainiest area on earth. Cherrapunji already has its own reason to be known across the world. The place recorded the maximum rainfall for a single day in the year 1876, when 1040 millimeters of rain fell here on one given day. And in July 1861, it recorded the highest rainfall in a month. Reverend Thomas Jones of the Welsh Mission set foot here in the year 1841 and spread Christianity from this village to the entire present-day Meghalaya. Reverend Jones, along with Reverend William Lewis and their wives, also developed the Khasi alphabet in the Roman script here. It was here that U Omar and U Rajon, two Khasi tribals, were first converted into Christians. They were baptized on the 8th of March 1846 by Reverend Lewis. The first church in the hills of the northeastern frontiers was also established here at Nongswalia near Cherrapunji in the same year, 1846. It was in this church at Nongswalia that the missionaries converted Karnabon, the first Khasi lady, into Christianity. That was on the 16th July 1848. The church building that we see today is an improvement of the original church that had crumbled in the devastating earthquake of 1897.
भर बरसात में डूबे मोरा गाँव कौन बचावे मोहे सुनी मोरी नाव भर बरसात में भर बरसात में बहता हवा में उड़ी उड़ी जा वही मोरा जाए भर बरसात में डूबे मोरा गाँव कौन बचावे मोहे सुनी मोरी नाम भर बरसात में भर बरसात में भर बरसात में
खो रामा ऑल्सो नोन एज मोट्रॉप is an imposing single drop formation in the shape of a giant cone. According to legend, this was the fossilized cone-shaped basket of an evil giant. Six kilometers from the Cherrapunji market to the south lies the village of Mosmai. From this clearing, a concrete pathway through the jungle leads up to the main cave entrance. At the end of the river passage, there's a sharp left turn to the east into high conical-shaped ovens. To the south of 300 meters walking size passage ends in a cluster of boulders. Thank you. The caves are a unique and a very special part of our natural environment. Their slow and gradual formation over many thousands of years have resulted in fantastic passage shapes where breakdowns occur, sediments are deposited, and beautiful calcite formation built up, where various creatures find a home. Myriad of stalactites and stalagmites are also common inside, which not only reflect the lights and enliven the internal environs, but also seem to radiate a million crystal colors of the walls of the cave. To enter such a place is an experience unlikely to be forgotten, and unfortunately, one that only a few people, like our unit members, were fortunate to have been. Cherrapunji is a place to discover the Indian summer monsoons, a unique annual meteorological phenomena, directly influenced by the northwest monsoon and the northeast winds. The heavy monsoon rains over these mountains perhaps create one of the rainiest biodiversity vegetation in the world. It's truly a unique corner in Northeast India, just waiting to be discovered and explored. The Thangkarang Park is situated on the road that links Mausmai to Shela. It is a park maintained by the State Forest Department, which has a rich collection of many rare and highly endangered species of plants and orchids that are endemic to this area. Vishal, our director, next took us to a vantage spot. Actually, a viewpoint, virtually on a cliff that seems to protrude out of the southern edge of the Meghalaya plateau. From here facing southward, we could see the plains of Bangladesh below, with numerous rivers and streams that the waterfalls of Meghalaya have become, flowing through paddy fields of our neighboring country. Driving through Meghalaya countryside has always been an adventure. This is more because of the highway being replete with innumerable hairpin bends, which indicate the difficult terrain through which these roads have been constructed. Quite often, after having driven over a kilometer or so on a typical Meghalaya hairpin bend, one finds oneself a mere few meters away across some deep chasm. Driving on such zigzag precipice roads was indeed a uniquely thrilling, though spine-chilling experience for us. Cherrapunji, like all other areas of the Khasi Jaintia region, is under a CM, or a tribal chieftain, who is revered like a king by his subjects. The CM's office is still a vibrant example of the concept of local self-government that the Khasis have been practicing since time immemorial. It functions from the Darbar Hall, located in the middle of Cherrapunji. Another unique sight to the outsider is the magnificent monoliths, standing tall and graceful to mark different occasions and incidents that may have been very, very significant to the community over the centuries. Such monoliths are erected not only to commemorate the dead, but also to mark special events of social importance. This particular kind of monument and burial structures has a wide distribution in many parts of Asia, Europe, and Africa, and the origin is rooted in antiquity. These rocks, the standing ones, are menhirs, and the Khasis call them Kimu Shinrang. The flat ones are dolmens, which are called Kimu Kintai in the local language. These menhirs and dolmens speak about mankind, about civilization, about the journey of mankind through Meghalaya, through Northeast India, along the little rivulets that flow down to the mighty Brahmaputra, below in the plains. They silently speak about an endless journey, what humanity is all about. Koble Menhirs, Koble Dolmens.
Omore sajna chale ka tum vinati kari teri paap pade tore kitna